Hello, my friends.
And welcome back, everyone, to ARK Scorched Earth. Sorry, first off, that I'm a little bit sick. I woke up this morning, I felt like crap, and I'm like, alright, I'm gonna try to get some more sleep. And then finally, my throat kind of got to the point where I'm like, okay, I think I should be able to talk over today's video, luckily. But, yeah, my throat's kind of killing me right now, which sucks. And, I spent a lot of the morning just in bed trying to feel better. Like I said, I'm feeling a bit better now, but that did limit how much I could grind, so I wasn't able to get a whole ton. I was able to get a lot of obsidian, though, which is pretty good. Because I thought we needed obsidian for the wind turbine. Turns out we don't, and I'm just dumb. We only need obsidian for the polymer, but it's kind of good anyways. We got the obsidian grind out of the way for the cannonballs. I didn't get anything new for the cannonballs either. We do just have a couple cannonballs. I repaired all my stuff, made sure we're actually coming in fresh. And I did learn how to make flak armor, so I thought for today's activities, right? Why don't we go ahead and let's craft up some metal armor here, shall we? Let's see how this goes. So while that's crafting, why don't we go ahead and turn this thing on, blast our ears with how loud it's going to be, and then we want to craft up 25 electronics. So 1, 2, 3, 4. I think that's enough. Yeah, so there we're going to have 25 electronics being crafted up. We have all of our creatures screaming, and the goal today, I want to make a wind turbine. I want to make some metal armor. I want to place the wind turbine. Are we going to connect it to an electrical system yet? Not necessarily. I don't know what electrical stuff we can really even connect it to, but I still really do want to do it. And then we're going to head out and try to tame an Argentavis, because that's the one last ingredient we need. We need a good level Argentavis for the activities with which we will participate. Speaking of that, I kind of do want to craft up. Do I have the hide for a sleeping bag? Anyways, let's go back inside. Why don't we finish crafting up the wind turbine? Let's put it down. Let's see what we can do with this. Go to structures, electrical, wind turbine. Look at that thing. And as soon as that's crafted, honestly, why don't we just start making a bunch of polymer? Let's use the rest of our stuff to make polymer. We're gonna need that anyways for the rocket launcher. We'll get about halfway to the polymer count. So honestly, it's part of the grind, but I'll do it. We're using the rest of our cementing paste we have there to do that. And then, do I still have cementing paste in here? I have a little bit. Okay, not much though, but we do have a fresh set of flak. Surprisingly lighter than I remember flak being, but I will take it. And now what we can do is equip every... No, not into the... We gotta be out of the screen first. And then if we go to our... Oh, I should turn this off or... Okay, now I'm gonna leave that on while you finish crafting. In the meantime, though, let's equip our beautiful new set of armor. The helmet doesn't even fit our face. Do you see that? It's like a nose guard. I look like an elephant.
Hello, my friends. I am an elephant.
Like, what? Literally. What the? Like, the mask has been molded into my face. I'm Bane. I'm literally Bane right now. I'm thinking just as well that we're going to put it over here. Right? Is this good? Still 65% west. We'll begin our wind turbine farm right about here. And as you can see, the wind turbine is turning. Look at that. Look at that, lads. Oh god, we're thirsty. Ah! Yeah, look at this thing though. So this is producing power, right? What options do we have? Demolish. That is the only option. Got it. Well, it's producing power. Now I just gotta come up with stuff to connect this to, but we have a wind turbine. Now how far out can I zoom out? Okay, so pretty far out here. This is pretty far out. This is rad, dude. Okay, I just kinda wanna get a good angle of this. Look at how epic it is. The wind turbine. Oh, welcome to the family, wind turbine. I guess those are some of the big ticket items that we're gonna try to work towards. First, probably a fridge. So before we venture out to tame our Argentavis, I just want to see exactly what a fridge will require. Refrigerator. We actually just need a couple crystals and some electronics. So, we could craft some electronics if we wanted to right now. I'll probably just make sure everything here is prepared by the time the next time starts. But don't I have crystals in here? I have crystals somewhere. I gotta find those. Alright, well, shenanigans aside, we will hopefully soon be hooked up with electricity as we advance. But before we advance, it is time that we grab ourselves an Argentavis. So before we do that, let's make sure that this guy's ready and rearing to fight. Make sure he's nice and good. And let's head on over. That thing is still Still growing. Alright, you keep on doing you, buddy. You keep on doing you. And then if we take the dire wolf, right? What is there to be seen? Where can we go for Argentavi? Now, I did everything I want to do back home, right? I think so. Ooh, name the Parasair, actually. So the votes are in. And for the dire wolf, drum roll, please. Okay, I can't really, like, do the drum roll trick because there's, like, but... Drum roll, please. And for the dire wolf, welcome to the officially named pack, Eclipse. So I saw a couple comments, actually a couple pretty high voted ones saying Eclipse, as you guys will see now. And I just thought that that was pretty good. And then they brought up some good points like, oh, if you name the last one Luna, what about Eclipse? And this one's kind of cooler because Eclipse is like kind of a darker color. So it's like, I don't know, does an eclipse like black out something or other? I don't know, my celestial bodies. And then for the Parasair, you guys took a note out of my book and, well, a lot of support for Jar Jar Binks. Well, I'm just gonna name him my way, which is Jar Jar Binks. There we go. We gotta name him the Star Way, and that's Jar Jar Binks. That's how we name it out here. And then we gotta parkour our way down! Ow. Also, make sure we keep on upping the weight of this guy so we can carry more cannonballs. That's going to be the biggest thing we can get out of him. But thank you to everyone who commented. I highly appreciate it. Thank you guys for partaking and taking like an active interest in this series, especially with the naming of our tamed animals. Hopefully, we can tame up an Argentavis today for you guys to tame up. So in your free time here, while we go on this little adventure, maybe in the back of your head, start thinking, start daydreaming. It's time to begin our hunt for the Argentavi. We're going to kill everything. Once it's dead, we're going to leave it there. And then we're going to attack. Oh no, the Argentavis is getting attacked. Oh, Argentavis, don't die to that saber tooth. That's going to suck really bad if that happens. Don't do that. Okay, so come on, draw an aggro. We're going to take you out up close. There you go. See you later. I'm not scared of no Carno. Okay, I should be scared. He's taking some damage. He's dealing some damage. Oh boy. Oh boy. Oh boy. Come on, take out the saber tooth. Take out the saber tooth. Don't die, buddy. I'm gonna protect you. I'm protecting you. I'm protecting you. I'm drawing the aggro. Drawing the aggro. Come on. No! Why does this always happen to me? Alright. Listen. God damn it. Our dire wolves weren't meant to live. They just weren't. Okay. We're coming home with a goddamn Argentavis at the very least. Okay. I refuse to take no for an answer. Dodge those things. There you go. Thorny dragon down. I'm coming home on a mount. I'm telling you that at the very least. And you guys, as awful as this sounds, I think I'll get prime meat out of you. So I will harvest you guys in a little bit here. Just don't fly away. I got an Argentavis to track down. Why do our hunting trips always go so south? That's why I don't like fighting with our dinos. They're not strong enough yet. You gotta go training or something. Alright, so there we got the Argentavis. We got a couple of them, actually. All we gotta do is draw the aggro and not get attacked by anything else. But I think we should be able to do that. So let's go to this. Hello, Argentavis. Oh! Oh, I almost got him. Almost. Almost. Come on, little buddy. Maybe. They're flying right past him. Argentavis, over here. Attack me. Hello. Hello. Juicy meat target. Nice. We got a hit. All right, so you're just going to come in for some strafe runs. We just got to hit him with the crossbow and then juke him out. Oh, I think we juked him out a little bit. Oh, is he down already? Oh, hell yeah. It's at level 15, but it's better than nothing. Now we got to protect this with our lives. So let's make sure we got narcotic on there. Anything here that could attack you? If not, I'm gonna go try to get some of that prime meat from the saber tooth, which I think drops some. I'm just gonna check. Vicinity. We're safe. We got some carnos down there. I don't think I can 1v1 a carno. I mean, I got metal armor, but still. I'm not that confident. Oh, we're out of water? Dude. Now's not the time to run out of water. Like, I threw all my cacti away. Okay, okay. There's no jug bugs here either. Time to start gathering berries. Right, we'll just get a ton of berries here. That's the game plan. We're just going to keep downing these. We're going to be living on the edge. This is why we got to get glass jars. Those are going to be super nice. Okay, there we go. So, God damn it, why? Why me? Always to me. Okay. Let's down some berries. That should be enough to give us a little bit of hydration. It's gonna slowly go up. Okay, so you're being harvested. Give me some prime. No prime there. Crap. You have a lot of normal meat. I'll take your chitin. Oh, I'm definitely taking that hide, the keratin. I will tame up another one of you, and you will be stronger this time. Only got some pelts out of you. Come on, you can at least help me out after death. I do have an idea with how we can deal with this, though. We could get some prime out of the Carnos by taking him out from a distance with our flame arrows, because flame arrows OP. We've established this. Yeah, actually. I'm thinking that's the game plan. We might be on the edge of dehydration, like, every single minute. Which is really, really poopy. Like, but it's alright, we got this guy here. We're gonna let him starve a little bit so we can just throw meat onto him once the time comes. Right? Hopefully it doesn't take too long either. But before that happens, we gotta go and take out some friends. We're not knocking out these Carnos, alright? They're part of the reason we lost our friend. So we can't do that. No shenanigans. We're equipping these flame arrows. We're gonna take them out and get some goddamned revenge. I know that I'm thirsty, game. Please, you don't have to tell me every 7 minutes. Not 7 minutes, it's way less than that. Okay, so there's a Carno over here. If we can parkour our way kind of to this rock, we should be able to take him out safely from up here. I missed, of course I did. There you go. Oh my god, no Carno. Bad Carno. Bad, let me just hit you. Okay, there you go. He's on fire. He's trying to climb up here. I won't let him. Yeah, Carno, get roasted. Get roasted. Oh, ho, ho. See you later, buddy. All right. Oh, we're stuck. Oh, I hear scorpions. Oh, God, this is not the position to be in. I don't want to get knocked out right now. I don't want this stuff to spoil. So I'm just going to kill this thing from a distance. Don't want to deal with you. Go burn. Oh no. Oh no, we got another Carno up here. Oh, please hit. No. Now's not the time to miss my shots. Like, really, I gotta hit these shots. This thing's gotta die before it gets to me. Alright, we'll finish it off here. This thing's a higher level Carno. Okay, we had the armor, though. We're gonna leave that thing dead for a little bit. There's a scorpion right by Argentavis. This is awful. Okay, he's still pretty unconscious, though. Flame arrows. We gotta make sure we have plenty of these for all of our taming trips, because they're so useful. We're still on the edge of dehydration throughout all of this, which really sucks. But it's alright. That thing down. Do you have some water on you? Anything water-related? Like, I guess berries. I'll take those. Yeah, so we're just gonna be pretty much trying to stay up to date on berries. That's what we're doing. Okay, so we got our prime meat. I don't want it to go bad here, because it's... Did it already spoil? Our prime meat already really? Really? Well, I'll be damned. How do I increase spoil timers? That's shenanigans. It already spoiled. Okay, there we go. Make sure to get these on there ASAP. There you go. What's your taming looking like? Almost halfway. In the meantime, we can hopefully try to get some more prime meat from some Carnos nearby. We don't have a ton of... Oh, hello. I'll take you. You're being drafted there, Metal Pick. I want plenty of you back home. Yeah, so I'm gonna struggle trying to get some water. Hopefully that struggle pays off. I might try to run around and find a water bug. But in the meantime, I will continue babysitting the Argentavis. Hopefully we can craft the saddle without a workbench. If we do need a workbench, though, it's gonna be a long ride home. But we'll figure it out. Other than that, though, I will talk to you guys when we're a little bit closer to completing the objective. Alright, guys, we got a couple Carnos up ahead. That'd be just enough prime meat to finish the job we're trying to start here. So, I'm gonna try my best here to aggro one of them. Hopefully just one of them. That's the dream. And then from there, grab ourselves some prime meat and reap the benefits of life. So, oh, I missed that. How do I miss that? Come on. There you go. We got hit on that guy. I think we've only aggroed him, which is good. Try to get him with some more flames. Start running. Why aren't you running? There we go. That was a level 6. And yeah, we only pissed him off. Nice. So we can. And also, I found a sketchy rock in the mountain. After we get our Argentavis and make the saddle, I checked out the saddle. We don't need anything special for it, luckily. Yo, give me one prime meat at least. Don't. Really, you're making me do this. Alright, game, you know, if you want me to labor away, I'll labor away. Your call. You're the game here. I'm only the player. Where is Mr. Carno? Don't let him get the jump on me either. But that really absurdly yellow rock, that is our friend the rock elemental, so. Yeah, with that thing. Don't move out the way. There you go. Alright. That's our friend the rock elemental. And, what we're gonna do after we get our Argentavis is we're gonna try to pick a little fight with him and see how that goes. So, there you go. Whoop! Oh my god, after he died, he tried to hump me. Freaking death hump over here. Did you see that? His crotch was flying into my face. So, as soon as we get this last raw prime meat, we are running for the hills! I gotta find out a way to increase spoil timers because raw prime meat spoils just so stupidly quick, honestly. But hopefully here, if we had a vulture, that'd be pretty helpful. Let's get all the raw prime in there ASAP. Awesome, it's gonna spoil in a minute 30 now, but the good news is he'll eat up one of them at the very least. And he's probably gonna be one or two meat away. And in the meantime, while that's going on, I got myself some chitin from the scorpions we murdered. We had plenty of hide available thanks to Eclipse's loss. I wonder what next celestial object we will name our direwolf after. We'll find out next time we get one. And we got plenty of fiber, so we're going to craft up the Argentavis saddle. Got a couple rare mushrooms here. The cool thing with these is we can use them to tame up a kangaroo. And as you remember, Trade Master, Caravan Master Taco brought a huge supply of these because apparently the kangaroos are like druggies. I don't know, dude. Okay, I'm not judging here. But apparently that's a thing, so we can actually tame kangaroos with the rare mushrooms. So we should have a big enough supply to tame one up if we really try. And all we need, it would be helpful if Taco came along so he can use the moth to actually poop on the scorpion, or poop on the kangaroo and make him really slow. And then after that we can bola him and just kind of continue barraging him with that type of stuff. So that's really good news. And this is actually a different mountain range. Last time we went to that mountain range. Okay, so this is kind of cool. So that's a completely different rock elemental. That's not one of the old ones that wandered over. That's going to be a new one. Or it might not be a rock elemental, but I refuse to believe that. And speaking of that, there's actually a really cool spot for taming up rock elementals that I think we're going to go to. It's a lot more south, but it is a cool trick. It is something that I think... who originally found it? I think it was Drax? Don't quote me on that, but I did find out about it through Drax, and I'm like, okay... That makes taming rock elementals about a bajillion times easier, so I'm going to try to show that off for you guys. And we will take things from there. But hopefully this Argent will eat his next meat. We're out of prime. Because that's the way this game works, unfortunately. So, he should be done here. Probably, it's probably going to take one more meat, isn't it? If it is, I'll just fast forward through this. Come on. Come on. Come on. Are you gonna eat? Like, hey! Got ourselves an Argentavis. Beautiful. You guys know the drill. Comment section down below. Hopefully you've been thinking. Hopefully you got something cool. Go ahead, leave a comment. And if you got some extra time, look through the comments. Like any comments that you see that you like. Because that lets me know what is the general consensus that you think, that you guys altogether think we should have. And it's a lot easier for just kind of my purposes. But we're going to take this opportunity. We're going to do a flyby here, right? I want to do a flyby by this thing. Although Argentavis is kind of slow. I'm scared we're going to get murdered. But if we fly right by this thing, we should... Oh, it's moving. It's moving. Oh, Nelly. Yeah, that's a bona fide rock elemental. Look at that thing go. Well, look at that. Yeah, well... We know where to find a rock elemental at the very least. There's one up in this mountain range. Not this, but this mountain range doesn't have like a cool spot we can use for an easy tame. Either way though, we might try it out. We'll see. In the meantime though, let's get to flying. Let's check out the red airdrop. We've actually never really prioritized airdrops, and I'm pretty sure that we're high enough level to finally get one. And after that, we'll just head on over to that waterfall right there, and that's the place we call home. So actually, we're really close to two mountain ranges. I didn't realize that. I thought we were just close to one, but that makes things a lot easier. But everyone, say hello to our beautiful Argentavis. Oh, look at the sun. Look at the sun behind him. He looks so angelic. Yes. That is us. Now, let's head on over here. Snatch this thing up. Hope there's nothing aggressive on the ground. There's some sort of a building. I kind of want to check that out real quick. But the good news is hopefully we'll get to level this guy. We're going to crank movement speed on him. We need movement speed insanely high for what we're trying to do. So that's going to be the goal. Pretty much just get a bunch of XP for the Argentavis and put like all of it into movement speed, because that's how we're going to hopefully survive the onslaught of dragons. But 70? Really, dude? Really? Of course red is 70. The one color. I'm pretty sure that's the one color we cannot currently grab. Well, thanks, game. Thanks. Anyways, there's some kind of cool ruins up here. We'll check that out, but after that, we'll head on home. Slightly defeated that we lost a direwolf. Maybe it's a sign. Direwolves just don't go together with me, right? They always attack me and try to kill me. And if they're not attacking, if they're even if they're in my pack, they die. It sucks. They die. But anyways, this Argentavis is good too. We'll be able to use this for taming up the rock elemental. So hopefully Taco will be. Oh god, he's flying after me. I just wanted to explore these ruins. Oh, that's really cool. A leap of faith. Oh, yeah. No, not trying that. Argentavis, come on, buddy. I'm not leap of faithing onto you. Get your buns back here. Come on, get those pretty buns over here. I'm hungry. There you go. All right, and then we're gonna be cranking up movement speed. Goes up by 2.5%. So we gotta level this guy a ton, but we'll just go on some training runs with him and take things from there. But other than that, we should be able to head on home to a pretty successful episode, minus the whole death part. Okay, that's not our home. Over here? Is this even our general home area? Oh god. Oh no. This could be bad. Is this not home? Oh no, home's up ahead. It's the next waterfall down. Okay. Okay, I was starting to panic. I'm just like, we entered Narnia. Now we're safe. We're good. Alright, I'm not- okay, I want to poop as a person. Anyways, we got our giant parasaur back there. The welcoming site of home. And the welcoming site of a new mount to enter the home with. I'm really excited for this. I'm really excited for what's going to be coming. And we're hopefully going to be getting that rock elemental pretty damn soon, boys. Pretty damn soon. But other than that, I'm going to park the Argentavis. We're going to bask in the beauty of our new wind turbine that we can hopefully incorporate. I'll probably try to do that in one of the next couple episodes as well. Start doing some electricity stuff. Stop following me, Argentavis. I know you're probably trying to follow me. And we just got good things ahead. I think I hear a storm coming on. So, yeah, it sounds like there's a storm coming. So we're going to go ahead, head inside, retire for the night, and try to get a good night's sleep after a very successful day here at the Starsnipe ARK Scorched Earth series. And we need some water. Camel, get over here. I'm going to drink your water. Give me that water. There you go. Thank you. Anyways, we're going to find some shelter from this. And we got to craft a bed, don't we? We really do have to get that going. So let's just research it. Simple bed. Yeah. Two mattresses. Half the cooldown time. Yeah, I'm just... Can I make a simple bed? Wooden fiber. I'm lazy. I'll figure that out in the meantime. But other than that, that is going to go ahead and do it for me. Thank you, everyone, so much for watching.
And goodbye, my friends.